The Israelites wanted to have a king, and God gave them Saul, although he knew that this wasn't really the right thing for them, but that's what they wanted, and so they had Saul, and he warned them that Saul was not going to be a very good king. Although Saul didn't have to be bad, he started off a good king, but he went wrong. And so we read then, this is 1 Samuel 13, that Saul reigned 2 years over Israel. And Saul chose some 3,000 men of Israel. 2,000 of them were with Saul in Michmash, and 1,000 of them were with Jonathan his son in Gilboa. And the rest of the people he sent each man to his tent. Jonathan attacked the garrison. Do you know what a garrison is?
No.
A garrison is when a country comes and invades you, an army invades you, and they put some of their soldiers in a kind of a castle or a fort or a strong place so that they can govern the people that they've conquered. And so the Philistines had a garrison that was in Geba, and Jonathan attacked them. And Saul blew the trumpet throughout all the land, saying, "Let the Hebrews hear." And all Israel heard that Saul had smitten a garrison of the Philistines, and that Israel was now hated by the Philistines. So the people were gathered together after Saul to Gilgal. And the Philistines gathered themselves together, 30,000 chariots, 6,000 horsemen, and people as the sand on the seashore in multitude. And they came up against the Israelites, and the men of Israel saw that they were in a difficult position. And they ran away to hide themselves in caves and in forests and in rocks and in high places and in pits. Now, some of the Hebrews went over the river Jordan to the land of Gad and Gilead. And so Saul was in Gilgal, and all the people followed him trembling. They were very frightened of these Philistines. Now remember, Samuel had told him that after 7 days he would come. Well, Saul waited 7 days, according to the time that Samuel had appointed, but Samuel didn't come to Gilgal, and the people started to run away from Saul. Saul said, "Well, bring here the burnt offering to me and the peace offerings." And he offered the burnt offerings. Now, who was supposed to offer the sacrifices?
The priests.
The priests, that's right, the Levites. And was Saul a priest?
No.
Do you remember what tribe he was from?
Benjamin.
That's right, he was from Benjamin. Well done. Not from Levi. So he shouldn't have done this. So Samuel said, and it happened, as soon as he had finished offering the burnt offering, Samuel came. Saul went to meet him and that he might greet him. And Samuel said, "What have you done?" Saul said, "Well, I saw the people were running away from me and you hadn't come. And the Philistines were gathered together against me. So I thought, well, the Philistines will come down now upon me to Gilgal, and I haven't made any offering unto the Lord. So I forced myself and I offered the burnt offering." Samuel said to Saul, "You have done foolishly. You have not kept the commandment of the Lord your God, which he commanded you. For now would the Lord have established your kingdom on Israel forever, but now your kingdom will not continue. The Lord has sought him a man after his own heart, a man who thinks like God. And the Lord has anointed him to be prince over his people, because you have not kept what the Lord commanded you." Now, who was the man after God's own heart? Who was going to replace? Who came after Saul? And so he was the man after God's own heart. And it says that God has searched for a man after his own heart. So God saw everybody in Israel, all the young men, and he looked at them all, and he saw that David had a heart that thought like his. So God is looking at everybody, looking at everybody's heart. And it's so important to God how we think. And that is what Christianity is really about. It's about how you think when nobody's looking. That is what it is to be a Christian, to have the Spirit of Jesus, to be spiritually minded. Well, it might seem that God was a bit kind of tough on Saul. But I think the point is that God does ask obedience from us. And if he says that there are certain things that are his principles, then we've got to stick by them. And Saul just thought, well, it doesn't really matter. I can do it. And he did so because he was frightened, not because he loved God, but because he was scared. And he thought, oh, well, I better do something for this God. I better make some sacrifice or something, because he was very scared and frightened. And so because of that, as Samuel says to him, his kingdom was taken away from him. This was only after 2 years. And so the lesson is for us that although God is very generous and he's very gracious and very forgiving, God is also serious. And we need to be serious about God if we want to continue in the way of the kingdom.